Amen.
Yeah, hallelujah, brother.
Hallelujah. Yeah. I'm in this church. This glorious church. Yes. I didn't join. I was born. I had a new birth. Maybe we got too many people joining. And they ain't born. And they ain't. Somebody writing their name on a man's book. Amen. Amen. I want to talk to you a little bit tonight. Amen. Maybe teach a little bit. It's important that we, let's begin. My people are destroyed because they don't know. They perish because they don't see. Now he says you'll know the truth. And the truth is what liberates you. The music was wonderful tonight. I enjoyed it so. And that music, amen, it prepares us, amen. It prepares us, amen, to enter. You know, there's thanksgiving, praise, and worship. And worship is that place of oneness with God, where we're saturated with His very presence, amen. Where we leave the outer court and the holy place, and we enter into that secret place, where we submit to the anointing, and we're saturated with the Shekinah glory, and our countenance begins to glow, and it's the light that drives the darkness away. Somebody say amen. So let's talk a little bit tonight. Now, he says, you'll know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Now, he says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and don't forget there's some benefits when you're born again. Amen. Now, is it all right to tell you, make sure you're born again. Amen. God forbid. Do we get all mixed up? We finally get somebody to the altar, and we got one on one side saying, hold on, hold on, hold on. And we got one over here saying, turn her loose, turn her loose, turn her loose. Hallelujah. Just let them kneel down and pray and cry. Just leave them alone. Amen. Till they're born again. Amen. We got to be born of the Spirit and of the water. Somebody say amen. And now let's look. Hallelujah. There is Passover. Hallelujah. Justification. There is Pentecost. Sanctification. Amen. Then there's glorification. Somebody say amen. So it's a process that he wants us to grow. So maybe we can look at a picture tonight. I believe, will you bring that jug of water beside you, Wayne? Amen. I believe I showed some of you this. Amen. Once before. Amen. But I want to go a little further tonight. Take that lid off for me. Now watch what the Bible says. He says, let's let this be the body. Let's let this be Jesus here. Can you see it all right? He says, all the fullness of God dwells in
Jesus.
In him. And who is him?
Jesus.
Thank you. Y'all pretty smart people.
Come on,
all the fullness of God is in him.
Uh-huh.
Now he says, in him you live and move and have a being. Uh-huh. In him is life. Amen. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
In him we have obtained redemption through the blood.
Uh-huh.
In him we have obtained an inheritance.
Uh-huh.
In him, this is it right here. In him you are complete.
Right.
Well, somebody said, boy, that's what I need. I need to get in him. Amen. Amen. But there's a danger of feeling the presence of the Lord and not being in him.
Amen.
But there's a danger of dancing to the music and not being in him. So what's the only way to get in him? By one Spirit. Now, I thank God. When a man put me down,
uh-huh. Oh, go ahead.
Hallelujah, in the water,
uh-huh.
Amen. But I hear Jesus saying, I hear John saying, all I got's water.
Come on.
All I got's water. But it ain't over. Somebody else coming here. Hallelujah. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost in fire and by one Spirit. Now watch. Passover, we're without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. So we're justified by the blood. We are washed in the blood, and our sins are remitted. We're no longer black, but we're white. Now watch the importance of the baptism of the Holy Ghost. By one Spirit, you've got to have the Holy Ghost. Somebody say amen. You've got to. Thank God. By one Spirit, we are baptized into one body. Somebody say amen. And I love her talking about preserves. I like to eat them, and I like to talk about them too.
Amen.
And he said, when you're baptized, your life is
hid
with Christ.
In God.
And now watch now. Watch what happens. I told you that my dad got out of work in West Virginia. He went to Cleveland, Ohio to get a job. And he got a permit with this pretty little black-headed woman. That was my mommy. Amen. And he said, he introduced himself. How many's heard of Jesus?
Come on.
That ain't enough.
Amen. Come on.
He said, I'm Bill White. He said, I'm Angelina Cirelli.
Come on.
He bought her some flowers. She was still Angelina Cirelli. He took her some candy. She was still Angelina Cirelli. He was Bill White. Let me show you how important this is. Your commitment, your baptism. Amen. Hallelujah. But one day he said, hallelujah. Would you like to marry me?
Come on.
He said, now, if you marry me, I'm going to take you away from here. I'm going to take you out of Cleveland. I'm going to Ohio, and I'm going to take you to West Virginia. Hallelujah. I'm going to take you away from your mommy. I'm going to take you away from your daddy. But I'm going to be your provider. Amen. I'm going to be your protector. Amen. He said, I know your daddy took care of you. I know he worked and fed you. Hallelujah. But if you want my name, if you want my name, if you want my name, I don't know if you want his name. Hallelujah. But you got to leave your mommy and you got to leave your daddy. Amen. You still got to love him, but you got to love me more. Somebody say amen.
Come on.
So we're going to do this right. We're going to get a preacher and make a confession.
Huh?
And you got to say, I swear, I will love you for better or for worse. Sickness, health, rich or poor, till death do us part. Now watch what happens. I need something here. A blanket or a something. A big long coat. Yeah. Something. We're talking about baptism now.
All right.
Praise God. And they go before the preacher. She said, I swear I'll leave my mom and daddy. I want your name. And so they make this commitment to each other. Now he made a commitment to me. He said, I'll never leave you, son. I'll never forsake you. Amen.
Come on.
They make their commitment. They kiss, and he don't say, the preacher don't say, I give to you Bill White and Angelina Cirelli. I give to you Mr. and Mrs. Bill White. Now watch what happens. Come up here and help me. Amen. Stand up here beside of me. She loses her identity.
Come on.
You are dead and your life is hid with Christ. She is no longer Angelina Cirelli. I hope y'all hear me. If you send the package to Angelina Cirelli, she won't get it. If you send a letter to Angelina Cirelli, she won't get it. Because she's dead. She's become one with him. And she's his responsibility. He protects her. He provides for her. She is Mrs. Bill White. She no longer exists in the old form. Now watch. It says, and grieve not. Huh? Don't you call him. Put that lid on her real tight for me, brother. He said, I sealed you. How long? Till you mess up.
Come on.
Till you make a mistake.
Come on.
I seal you.
Come on.
Till the day of redemption. He said, now don't grieve me and tell me you can't make it and it's too hard. And he goes like this, and you are sealed. Now see there, you can't find you in there.
Come on.
Because you are dissolved. You talking about a Jesus man. Hallelujah. Now let's go a little further. If I could get my assistant back there to help me just a little bit. Amen. I want you. Now he says, in him you live and move and have your being. In him you've received redemption by the blood. In him you're circumcised with the circumcision made without hands. In him you are complete. You are what God ordained you to be. Somebody said, amen. But it's not only, just sit there right in the middle there. I'm going to give somebody some boxing lessons here in a minute. Praise God.
Come on, bro.
Hallelujah. Now, it's not only about being in him. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. What's the next two letter words? If you open up, what I want in.
Yes.
I want in.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all help me preach that. I want in. This might be too slow for y'all. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want you to learn something. God forbid we let that devil mess all over us. Hallelujah. Praise God for Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Now he says, to whom God would make known, he said, I want you to understand the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles. Well, what is the glory? It's Christ in you, the expectation of glory. He said, you're not only in me, I want to be in you. I want to live in you. Oh, somebody help me preach. I got to take my time here. He said, even as the witness of Christ is confirmed in you, when Christ is in you and the light of the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ begins to radiate, the darkness has to go out of that sinner, out of that addict. Somebody say amen. The only thing effectual against darkness is the light, and you are the light of the world. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Know ye not, destroyed for lack of knowledge, that you are right now the temple, and the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Amen. Amen.
I don't have to pray it down. I don't have to pray it out. What did I say the other night? He said, I made your mouth the sharp sword.
Come on, everybody.
I can't go back on that. He said, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. But really, it ain't me. But Christ liveth in me. Oh, glory. I can't believe y'all ain't shouting. You are of God, little children. You listening? You are of God and have overcome them. Why? Because greater is he that is in you. In you. In you.
Come on.
I'm having fun.
Hallelujah.
Y'all don't know this is my vacation.
That's right.
Yeah.
I've been on vacation for 50 some years.
Come on! Now
listen to this.
Come on.
It pleased God who separated me from my mother's womb and called me by his grace. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Why did you separate me from my mother's womb and call me? To reveal your son in me. You are to be a revelation of the mighty God Jesus Christ. You are created to be in his express image, predestinated to be conformed to the image. I hear him say, Jeremiah, I sanctified you before you come out of there, boy. I chose you, I called you. But Jeremiah, he got discouraged and didn't preach, and the people made fun of him and made faces. He said, look here, Jeremiah, I want you to go down to the potter's house. Amen. He went down to the potter's house and he made a vessel. Hallelujah. And it was marred. He made me and I wasn't made right. He created me and I messed up. He created me, but he didn't throw me away. He's not only the maker, he's the remaker. He's not only creator, he's the recreator. Well, I'm almost there.
Thank you. Bless him, Lord.
Teach us,
Lord.
We don't know. We said, oh God, would you please? And he said, oh son, would you please?
Amen. Yeah, come on.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come
on.
Just a little bit more. Hallelujah. He said that he would grant you. That he would grant you, to grant as a gift, according to the riches of his grace, to be strengthened. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
With might by his spirit in the inner man.
Come on.
For which cause we faint not, because the outward man is perishing, but the inward man is getting stronger and stronger. We're about to see, Bo, a revelation of the true sons of God, separated, called out, dedicated, sanctified, set apart, and vessels of honor, filled with the Holy Ghost and power, walking by faith, mighty men of valor, set out under the anointing of God to set the free, to loose those that are bound by addiction, to deliver those who have a problem. These mighty men, they march by faith.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Come
on. Thank you,
Jesus. He does. Some people say, somebody told me, some brother puts on some burden. I said, boy, I am too. They said, you are? I said, yeah. He daily loadeth me with benefits. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Yeah. Come on. Thank you.
Praise
Jesus.
God. Now listen to this. He, how many knows
what this is here?
You said in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word, it was God. And the Word was made one. So the flesh is the Word, and the Word was the flesh. And he turned around and said, except you eat my flesh. And he's talking about the Word.
Amen.
Is that what you said?
Amen.
Except you eat my flesh.
Yeah.
And drink my blood, Holy Ghost. But he that eateth my flesh, and he that drinks my blood, dwelleth in me, and I in him. Oh! Hallelujah. Oh, it's better. He said, I'm going to send you. I'm going to send you another comfort. I ain't going to leave you by yourself.
Uh-huh.
Amen. As a matter of fact, I'm going to come in person. He said, now, the comfort is, he said, what are you going, God, what are you going to comfort me with? The spirit of truth.
Uh-huh. Come on.
The world can't receive it.
Uh-huh.
Because it can't see it.
Uh-huh.
Don't know it, but you know him,
yeah.
For he dwelleth to give you a principle. You overcome because greater is he that's in you. Now, in the world, you're going to have tribulation. Somebody going to mess with you. Somebody going to...
Come on.
Somebody gonna kick you.
Come on.
Somebody gonna spit on you.
Come on.
Somebody gonna offend you. But the Creator put something down in this thing right here that no matter what you do to it, it comes back to the truth. Somebody say, I don't know what you got.
Amen.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh, the grave.
will shine.
Lay hands on her.